Hiya, welcome back to my channel. I'm quickly going to do a what's in my hospital bag video, and I purposely recorded this part of the video after I came out of hospital. I've been in labor, I've had baby. You can watch my labor video if you missed that, but I actually wanted to see what I would be using in hospital so that you could like know what to take and what not to take if you are in my shoes. Please feel free to check the description box for some of the items that I got off Amazon or online with the direct links. I got these like really cute organizer bags from Amazon in yellow, of course, my favorite color. You can get any bags pretty much. If you have like those, if you ordered from Shein in the past, you can use those bags. Just any like little organizer bags so that you can put the things that you're using in different categories in different places, so it's easy to grab. That was something that was super helpful with me in hospital. But let's get into it and see what I had in my hospital bag. The categories I had, one was a toiletry bag, which literally just had shower gel, my toothbrush and toothpaste, sponge, and then I had my skincare bag, which was whatever skincare I used, whatever skincare you use. I would definitely say take your skincare bag, like have your skincare. It just helps you feel refreshed. And if you're like me, and if you listen to my labor story, you will know I was in hospital for a week. So thank God I took that because it just allowed me to feel refreshed. One thing I definitely would say is buy everything new. Like it doesn't have to be fresh, like the best stuff, but just buy a new toothbrush, buy a new toothpaste, buy new shower gel or soap, whatever you use, because I was thinking, oh, when labor comes or when I'm going, I'll just take my old stuff. But sometimes you don't have time. Two, you don't have time to start thinking about that. So literally just buy a new toothbrush, buy a new soap, buy a new shower gel, and pack that already down. With skincare, obviously, you can't like buy, you don't have to buy new stuff, but just make sure everything's prepped already. You just grab the bag and pop it in your suitcase. Then the next category is your sleepwear. I took two types of pajamas. One was a button-down dress and one was top and trousers. Make sure it's a button-down dress if you are taking a dress, because you'll be breastfeeding, or you're going to try at least if you are. And if you're a first-time mom and never been pregnant, you wouldn't think of that, because all my like pajama dresses are just like gowns. So I specifically remembered to get one that was a button-down to make it easy to bring out the boob. Literally, I would say two pajamas max. You can even go with one if you know you're not going to be there too long. And then slippers, any comfortable slippers that you can just wear, slippers for the bathroom and slippers just for around the hospital room as well. And then of course your bonnet if you are going to be covering your hair. The next category I had was underwear, anything to do with like the bits, the underpart. So I took period pants. I took two period pants. I took two normal pants. And then I took a bunch of period pad pants, and they were super helpful. Like it was so lovely to not have to start looking for pants and add the pad to the pants. I just had the pull up pads. If that, I don't know what they're called, but you'll see it in the video. The pull up pad pants. I got the ones from Tesco. Much, much better than the Always ones. They fit. If you're like me, you got a round booty, you kind of thick. That was much better. Discreet Tesco ones, and I got the largest size. I got one pack, but I would advise you to get two. One for the hospital, but then like when you're home, you'll need more. So I'd say get like two packs of that. And then I did pack a lot of stuff for vaginal recovery because I thought I was going to have a vaginal birth, but I didn't. So that's the Peri bottle. I got the spray that you spray on the pad to maybe ease the pain, and then witch hazel wipe. I didn't have a vaginal birth in the end, so I didn't use any of those, but it was good to have it just in case. Another section was goodies, like anything that makes you feel good. I got cereal bars. I got my favorite chocolate, of course, water, but you can get that at the hospital as well. Then little snacks to make you feel good. Don't stock up, but get a few. They came in handy for me because I ended up staying longer than I was supposed to anyway, so that was really nice to have. Breastfeeding bras, but I didn't even end up using a bra because it was just easier to just whip it out. No need to be in a bra anyway. So clothes as well. I took an outfit that I'll be wearing back home from the hospital, and then I took an outfit to wear in the hospital. I was pretty much always in, I got the hospital gown when I got there and then just changed that a few times because I didn't plan to be there for so long. So, but yeah, really you just need clothes to go home in, and then maybe just two options just for safety. You just never know. Of course, I took my towel, which is really handy. And I also took a speaker, which was super helpful because I was playing music all through. I had a birth playlist and it just helped me be calm and help me be in good spirits. It was Christian music and I was just able to meditate and pray. And it was really helpful to keep me in a good mind space. And then baby stuff. So I had just a bunch of newborn onesies, be sure to get different sizes because you don't know how big or small your baby's going to be. So I took newborn onesies and I took 0 to 3 months and I took 3 months. So I think I took two of each just to be safe. I also took socks and I took mittens. That was pretty much it. Then I also got a bunch of freebies, free newborn Pampers, free newborn bottles and stuff like that. So I took one pack of the newborn Pampers that I got, which was like a pack of four. And that's just because you don't need to take too much. If you don't have it, the hospital will give it to you and you won't be there for too long anyways. Now, depending on how you want to feed your baby when your baby arrives, this will determine what you're taking with you. I definitely wanted to breastfeed, but I wasn't sure what that experience would be like for me as a first-time mom. So I took two bottles of formula milk, two different brands, because I wasn't sure which would be best or what you'd like. But even when I got to the hospital, they provided that for me. So my hospital provided like enough formula for me to use till my milk started coming out. But I took some in case and I didn't end up using it anyways. And they did provide like little bottles as well. So you don't necessarily need to take bottles either. Then I had another little bag section where it had like muslin cloths, burping cloths for my baby. And then two types of blankets. One was like a cloth blanket. One was like a woven blanket. Just because I didn't know which one we'd use. So I also took those to the hospital as well. Do not forget to take clothes for your baby to go home in. I got this really fluffy jacket thing, and I would advise getting, like, depending on the country you're in, obviously if it's nines you don't need to do that, but if it's England, definitely get them like a onesie that's like very warm to put them in before they go in the car seat, because obviously it's going to be very cold. And yes, they are wearing clothes, but they need layers. And then finally, in my handbag, I had my charger, I had a power bank, I had my AirPods, I had a comb. Definitely carry a comb if you are planning to have natural birth. You're meant to press on there when you have contractions, so it sends the pain to that part and so you don't feel too much pain. It did kind of work earlier on, but it could be different for you, so I would suggest you try it. You just never know. And I, of course, took my tripod that I used to film and my maternity notes. Do not forget that, because that's kind of like the easiest thing to forget. Put your maternity notes in there beforehand so you do not forget, because you'll be so annoyed if you get to the hospital and they don't have it and they need it and you need it. So that's pretty much what I had in my hospital bag. Please let me know if you have any questions. I would love to answer and help you. Thank you for watching. Bye.